I'll get back at him. In Luke 4:13, he says, "And when the devil had ended all the temptation, he departed from him for a season. And Jesus returned." Listen to this. This had not happened before. Remember the journey we're on here. He's 30 years old. We're just now learning about the beginning of his ministry. And Jesus returned in the power of the Spirit into Galilee. That's where he was from.
Amen.
And there went out a fame of him throughout all the region round about, because he'd been doing stuff. Because he had been empowered by the Spirit of God. Because the Spirit of God and the Word of God had come together. And you get them two together, now you got some power.
Amen.
And when you try to do things absent the Word of God, and only by the Spirit of God, you're not going to get much accomplished. You've got to know some Word. And if you try, just quoting the Scripture without some Spirit, it's a dead letter. But when you add the Holy Ghost, when you add the Spirit of God to the Word of God, it becomes a living Word.
Amen.
Woo! Glory! It becomes a living Word that is quick, powerful, sharper than any two-edged sword.
Amen. Amen.
Glory to God. So it must be important. Jesus went and he taught in their synagogues, being glorified of all. There in Galilee, he's working his way to his hometown. And he came to Nazareth, where he had been brought up. For 18 absent years that we know nothing about, he had grown to be 30 years old in Nazareth. And as his cousin, don't you know everybody there? Everybody in town knew him.
Yeah.
And when he had brought, when he brought up, and as his custom was, he went into the synagogue on the Sabbath day and stood up for to read. And there was delivered unto him the book of the prophet Isaiah. I don't believe he got in a hurry. He didn't quote from memory. He was the living Word.
Amen.
He found the place. He went to Isaiah 61 and 1. He found the place where it was written. He won't leave no doubt in anybody's mind. He found the place where it was written. The Spirit of the Lord is up on me. When did it come up on him? Y'all remember the journey now? Down there, when he met John at the river, the heavens were open. God began to testify about him. Because he hath anointed me to preach the gospel to the poor. Who's anointed who here? God had anointed his son.
Amen.
To preach the gospel.
Amen.
To the poor. You can't do much rich folks. Thank God for the poor. Thank God. Hallelujah. I kind of been on both ends of that. Middle class and poor as a whipping wheel, my mother would say. Poor as a whipping wheel. I don't know how poor a whipping wheel can get, but it must have been awful poor because we were poor. But thank God, God is concerned about the poor. And he don't like it when rich men oppress the poor. Hallelujah. Don't want to go off on that journey. Now, he said, he hath anointed me to preach the gospel to the poor. He hath sent me. Who sent him? Did not God so love the world that he sent his only begotten son? So, he was sent for a purpose. He didn't just send him into the world. Hey, go. He said, I don't speak none unless I hear my father speak it, and I don't do nothing, and first I see my Father do it.
Amen.
He wasn't willy-nilly, hit and miss.
Amen.
He has sent me to heal the brokenhearted, to preach deliverance to the captives. If you're in captivity today, Jesus here sets you free.
Amen.
And recovering of sight to the blind. And I don't believe that always means can't see. He wants my sight in the spiritual realm to be clear.
Amen.
He wants me seeing 20/20 in the spirit.
Amen.
Recovering of sight to the blind, to set at liberty them that are bruised, to set at freedom them that are crushed. Sometimes we do, we feel like it is. The weight of the world's upon us.
Amen.
Well, look, Jesus came to give you some freedom.
Amen.
To get you out under that load. And to preach the acceptable year of the Lord. And he did. Everywhere he went. And even when he sent his disciples, he said, when you go preach, the kingdom is nigh. The kingdom is not. See, and they took his words. And they thought something was going to happen immediately.
Amen.
But here 2,000 years later, and that kingdom of heaven is yet to come. The kingdom of God is right now. It's among us.
Amen.
We're living in the kingdom of God right now.
Yes. Amen.
Hallelujah. That spiritual kingdom. Hallelujah. He translated me out of it. From that power of darkness. He took me out of all that darkness. Yeah. And he says he translated me into the kingdom of his dear son.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. In the kingdom of his son. In the kingdom where his son's at. I'm in the kingdom where the son's at.
Amen.
Oh, glory to God. Hallelujah. Oh, yeah. Hallelujah.
Amen.
That's what he told us.
Amen.
I believe it.
Yeah.
Now, preaching, doing all these miracles, and I don't want to get too far away from this. So, as we go on down this journey with him, he calls his disciples to himself, and he goes to a mountain. And there, on this mountain that Jesus took Peter, James, and John with him, there appeared unto him Elias, which is Elias.